Today's points are military powers of the president, diplomatic powers, legislative powers, judicial powers of the president of India. Topics name the Union Executive. Now, what are the military powers of the president? The president has some military powers. Now, what are the military powers of the president? The president is the supreme commander of the armed force. The president is the supreme commander of the armed forces of India. He appoints the chief army, chief who is the head of the army. Who is the head of the army? He is appointed by the president. Means the chief of the army is appointed by the president. The Navy and the Air Force, as well as the heads of other defense services, they all are appointed by the president. The president can also declare a war or can conclude peace with any country whenever it is necessary to declare any war against any country. It is the work of the president, he can declare it. And at the same time, the president can sign the peace treaty whenever he considers it to be very important. He may sign the peace treaty. But before signing the peace treaty, the president is supposed to consult the Council of Ministers and the Prime Minister. And now, diplomatic powers, you know, diplomatic powers of the president. The president, you know, is the head of the union government. The president is the nominal or constitutional head of the union government. So as the constitutional head of the union government, the president has some diplomatic powers. Now, what are the diplomatic powers? He or she can appoint the ambassadors of the country and envoys to other countries, and also receive the same from other nations along with the letter of credence. In cases where the president, the foreign delegates or foreign diplomat is not, you know, found suitable, the president has the authority to ask that person to leave India. It is depending on the president to, you know, watch over the activities of the ambassadors of foreign countries. If he considers it to be not appropriate, his activities, behavior is not appropriate, in that case, the president can ask him to leave the country. These are the diplomatic power of the president. So the president, as the head of the union, the president appoints ambassadors, the president conveys message through his bilateral talkings, and at the same time receive other delegates, other ambassadors of different countries of the world. And in cases where he considers the ambassadors or important foreign diplomats, diplomat is not found suitable, the president can request him to leave the country. So these are the most important diplomatic powers of the president of India. The another one, legislative powers. What are the legislative powers of the president? The president is an integral part of the parliament and addresses, you know, the houses, the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. The president possesses certain legislative powers. Number one, the president has the power to summon the Lok Sabha, to adjourn the meeting of the Lok Sabha, either houses of parliament, means Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. The president can summon, the president can adjourn either houses of parliament, means both the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. He or she can summon a joint session of both the houses to resolve any deadlock between the houses. Another important power, legislative power of the president is the president has the power to dissolve the Lok Sabha on the advice of the Prime Minister before the term is over. You know, the term of the Lok Sabha is, 5 years, but before the Lok Sabha completes its normal tenure, 5 years term, the president can dissolve the Lok Sabha, but in that case, the advice of the Prime Minister is very important. As per the advice of the Prime Minister, the president can declare dissolve the Lok Sabha. And the president nominates 12 members to the Rajya Sabha from the fields of art, from the fields of, science, literature and social service. So distinguished persons of different streams are nominated as the member of the Rajya Sabha by the President of India. How many? Only 12. 12 members are nominated by the President from different streams of education, literature, social science, art, sports activities, science. So they are nominated by the President, but how many in numbers? 12 in numbers. They are nominated by the President of India to the Rajya Sabha. So these are the legislative powers of the President. Besides, another important legislative powers also strengthens presidential power in the country. In case the Lok Sabha does not have the adequate number of Anglo-Indian members, the president may nominate 2 members to the Lok Sabha. The president has 2 quotas for the Anglo-Indian members. Suppose the number of members from the Anglo-Indian community has become very less. In that case, the president can appoint 2 members from the Anglo-Indian community to the Lok Sabha. It is the special quota of the President of India. The President can, appoint 2 members to the Lok Sabha. Nominate 2 members to the Lok Sabha from Anglo-Indian community. The President grants sanctions for the introduction of certain bills, like money bill, bill for the creation of a new state, or a bill for alteration in the territories of states. For example, some territories are the part of union territories, but these territories had been demanding complete states. They had been demanding to be a complete state or to be complete states. In that case, the president's decision is final. The president signed the bill for making a new state from Union Territory. Then the territory would become State of India. And apart from this, the president, signed the money bill. Initially, it was Speaker who decides which bill, whether the bill is money bill or not. Then it is sent to the President. The President ultimately sign, although the President is bound to sign money bill and other bills, but the President can detain the process of signing. But in that case, ultimately the bill is signed by the President. And next word, the President can issue an ordinance in the country on 2 conditions. Number 1, when the Parliament is not in session, when the President thinks that immediate legislative action is necessary. In that case, the President can issue an ordinance. So, the President of India can issue an ordinance under such circumstances. Number 1, when the Parliament is not in session, and number 2, when the President considers it that immediate action is required. immediate action is required for the all-round development of the country, the president can issue an ordinance. So under these two circumstances, the president can issue ordinances. So these are the, you know, legislative powers of the president of India. And next one, judicial powers. What are the judicial powers of the president? The president can grant pardon for the punishment passed by any court in the following cases. Sometimes, some courts, high courts, supreme courts, they pass their verdict, they give their verdict, and according to that verdicts, someone is given death sentence. But a petition can come on behalf of that particular person in order to reduce the punishment. At least for a request comes for giving him lifetime imprisonment instead of death sentence. In that case, the president role is very important. The president can grant pardon for the punishment passed by any court, from high court or the supreme court, in case of capital punishment. If punishment is given by a court martial, if it is an offense against the union law, in that case the president can, you know, grant pardon for the punishment. But the president can seek advice from the supreme court on any question of law, but it is not compelled to follow the same. Acceptance of the advice given by the supreme court is his or her discretion. The president can seek advice from the supreme court, but it is not compulsory. It is depending on the terms and depending on the relationship and the acceptability of the president throughout the country. The president is advised by the supreme court, but the supreme court is not bound to advise the president. And president sometimes goes to the supreme court to seek advice because of that situation. Suppose one file came mentioning the record of a person, his illegal activities, and whether he has left any legal activities, any positive side. In that case, the president can try to save the life, at least life of that very particular offender who is given death sentence by the supreme court. The president, in order to protect the life of that very person, the president went through the file and the previous life history. The president tries to understand. If the president comes to a conclusion that the life of that very person is very important and his life must be saved from being death, that's why from being hanged, the president can take. In that case, the president can grant the petition of pardon. The president can grant pardon for the punishment, and ultimately, by doing it, the president can protect the life of that very person. So these are the judicial powers of the president. And whenever the president decides to do it, so generally, no one forced the president to change it. Any court or any other institutions, any other organs cannot try to make the president understand why did the president grant pardon. No one raises any question against the president, against the system of pardoning an offender by the president. Up to this, my dear students, thank you.